Handy Drums version 2.0, key mapping and pitch tuning. In addition to mapping every component available in a Handy Drums plugin, version 2.0 introduces simple pitch tuning for every instrument. Let's look into the details of what everything is and how to use it. The key mapping and pitch tuning panels are accessible by pressing the key mapping button. This panel contains all instruments available in the plugin, similar to colored keys, but displayed in a grid. The small panel on the top will display any incoming MIDI note and CC information, showing both the CC number and visualizing its value. This is very handy when figuring out what note or CC your MIDI controller is assigned to and sending to the plugin. Key mapping. Note indicators. As you play your MIDI controller or a MIDI loop through the plugin, the note indicators next to each instrument illuminate when that instrument is triggered. This makes locating a sound on the panel particularly easy. Drum pads. Hovering over any instrument name will reveal drum pads, allowing you to audition any instrument quickly at full dynamic range. Note, velocities are spread from low to high along the width of each pad, and when they are clicked, the intensity of the illumination indicates the note velocity played. Key assignment. To assign a key, note, to any instrument, select it from the drop-down combo box. Be aware that you can choose the same key for several instruments, and pressing the key will trigger them simultaneously. Strike to learn a key. If you are using a MIDI controller, such as a music keyboard or an electronic drum set, and you wish to map the plugin to it quickly, you can do so with a quick strike to learn functionality of Handy Drums. Engage the learning for any instrument by pressing the rounded button next to the combo box. The button will illuminate orange. Strike a pad or a key on your MIDI controller to assign it to the instrument. The Learn button will disengage, and the instrument will be mapped to your keypad as reflected in the combo box. Start fresh. If you wish to reassign all instruments to your custom map completely, it may be easiest to start fresh with a blank map. To do that, quickly hop over to the Preset Manager and recall the blank mapping preset from the available presets for the plugin. Then, head back to the mapping panel to complete your mapping. Once you configured the mapping to your needs, you should save it as a preset in the Preset Manager. If at any point you wish to revert to the original mapping, you can recall it in the plugin's Preset Manager. It is important to note that when the plugin is opened in a new session or opened as a standalone app, it will load its default mapping. To use your custom mapping, you must recall your saved preset within the Preset Manager. Blank mappings. At the bottom of the panel, you'll find a special mapping section allowing you to pick any available instrument and map any key to it. This enables you to map several keys to a single instrument. For example, if you're a keyboard player, you may want to map two keys to the snare drum to play rolls more easily. To achieve this, first select any of the available instruments from the instrument combo box. Next, select any note to be assigned to this instrument or use the Strike to Learn functionality to assign a note, as described previously. You can switch between the key mapping and pitch tuning modes by clicking the toggle buttons. As you switch to the pitch tuning mode, the panel's title on the very top will change to Pitch Tuning. You will notice that the Learn icons have also changed into Tuning Fork icons, and that the columns below them now display tuning knobs. Each instrument has a knob that provides pitch shifting up or down 6 steps by semitones when dragged up and down. When a knob is pressed, a pop-up will indicate its current value from -6 to +6, with 0 being the default with no pitch changes applied. Pitch tuning should be used in moderation if you wish to preserve the original character of the instruments, as they will inevitably sound more unnatural as you move further away from the original pitch. double-clicking the knobs will restore them to their default neutral position. Note indicators are still visible through these knobs, facilitating the easy location of the played instrument. You can easily assign any hardware MIDI controller to any fader by right-clicking on it with your mouse, selecting Learn MIDI CC, then moving the MIDI controller, or picking the CC EAT from the pop-up of available choices. All of these pitch tuning knobs are available as plug-in parameters within your DAW and can be accessed for automation. eDrummer mode. One last element you will notice in the top right corner of the screen is the eDrummer mode toggle button, which when toggled on, tailors the plugin to drummers using electronic drums. Any changes in the mapping will be instantly noticeable. If you haven't yet experienced the latest version of Handy Drums, head over to Goran Groove's library and get a free trial now. For more information about eDrummer mode or other aspects of our plugins, see our additional videos or the tutorials section of our website. Thanks for watching.